Good morning, friends, followers, subscribers, and my army of Trevorites. Thank you very much for continuing to watch my videos. But mainly good morning to the subscribers. Subscribers are the ones that make the channel grow, aren't they? Yes. Anyway, 2nd of January, which means today, my son Sebastian turns 13. He's a teenager now. Wow, how quick did that happen? It just seems weird, you know. I suppose, you know, the last few years in my life have been very, very turbulent with mental health breakdown, PTSD kicking in, all these things happening in my family, and being separated, moving out, you know, for a short period of time. Homeless, believe it or not. Lived in a van, my van that I bought, and which I've had to tell the police about because someone said Trevor's using the van for his own use. And I'm like, well, yeah, I bought the van. I actually did a fundraiser to buy the van to go and do good stuff with. And it all fell apart. So yeah, I did live in it. Then Safa helped me, moved into the Premier Inn for a short period of time. I think it was 2020 over Christmas. I think it was 2000. I can't remember. It might have been 2019. I really can't remember. And then having to get my little place. And yeah, so my son's, I wouldn't put any son through that, if I'm honest, but he's had to watch all. And I've remained, believe it or not, I've remained positive every step of the way. And yeah, and this is what happens, people, whenever you leave the military and you've been involved in serious combat and serious trauma, it ruins with your head and it ruins lives. It does. But you need to be resilient, strong, and you can get back if you have the right people around you. And this is the exact reason, I've never said this before, this is exactly why my circle of friends consists of very, very few people. Because even though I was going through all that, people were still asking me for help. The same people that never said, "Do you need help?" And that's why I shut my door on dozens and dozens of people, and now I don't do that. Anyway, listen, as I was saying, I'm really proud because today my son's been through all that with me, been through stuff with his mum. We've both kept it together for him, and he's turned into a wonderful human being. I mean, he shows compassion when he plays with his friends. He shares a lot, you know. He looks after people. He's actually, at the minute, he stepped up to stop one of his friends, one of my neighbours, whose kids were being bullied, and he stepped in to stop that. I mean, I'm really proud of him. And I look forward to watching him turn into a young man now. Yeah, I mean, wow. Very proud moment. So there we go. Anyway, as I said, it's the 2nd of January. And yeah, a great day. I've already spoken to him this morning. Clearly, of course I have. So what's going on then? Well, I think you'll know that a couple of days ago, was it, might have been yesterday, day before, I can't remember, probably yesterday, that I reported on something which was in the media, and that was that thousands of sexual offences throughout the UK towards men and women are going uninvestigated. The police aren't investigating them. It's shocking. And these are facts. It's shocking. The police aren't investigating thousands of sexual offences. But guess what they're doing now, which makes me sick to my core. Right. I'm sure you've heard of virtual stuff where you put these glasses on or you watch these 3D shows. It's not real, but you're watching a virtual reality thing. Facebook has a thing called Metaverse where you put these glasses on and you're in a pretend room. And you've got avatars. You know what an avatar is? An avatar is a cartoon version of you. That's all it is. Anyway, listen to this. Police are now investigating a virtual rape. Yes, you heard that right. They're investigating a virtual rape. Not a real rape, virtual rape, right? In Metaverse, which is Facebook. When a young girl's avatar was sexually attacked by a group of adult men's avatars. Yeah, you're hearing that right. So the police are going to investigate the fact that a group of male avatars raped a girl's avatar It's a make-believe virtual reality nonsense, but the police are going to investigate that. I swear to God, the person who decided to put that out as an investigation needs sectioned. They're mentally unstable to be in charge of the police. They really are. And the fact that they're making a big deal out of this, it's absolutely shocking. And that's why things are falling apart. Real women that get sexually assaulted are having to go with no investigations as the police do this nonsense. It makes me angry. It makes me angry. And it also proves why a lot of men take the law into their own hands. And that's how you got to do it these days, people. If you go report things to the police and it doesn't happen, you have to bide your time, like I've been doing, and then you have to do things yourself. You really do. Shouldn't have to. Quite sad, isn't it? Yes. I will have a happy story shortly. Well, I'll just give you one about my son. I'm really proud of him. Yeah. Right. 24-year-old man called Gregor Lynn went to his doctor's. Yes, he went to his doctor's. He was complaining of, I think it's called a lesion on the back of his neck. Bit painful, bit of a lesion there, bit painful. The doctor checked it out. Guess what, people? And I will leave a link in the description. I had to write this down to get it right. What did I write here? Right, the doctor told him, right, that it did not fit the health service criteria. I'm sorry, Gregor, but that does not fit the health service criteria for me to do further investigation. That was in 2019. He's passed away now, the poor guy, with skin cancer. Because it was the start of skin cancer. He had skin cancer. But, you know, it didn't fit the health service criteria for an investigation by the GP. Well, Gregor, it's a sad end to probably a wonderful life. I hope that with this information, your family can sue the doctor and sue the NHS for neglect resulting in death. It's absolutely shocking. It's just another story of failed NHS. Do you know what, people? I'm not hearing any positive stories about the National Health Service. I'm really not. And as I said, I will continue to say, people say, Trevor, where do you get information from? That's wrong. And do you know what makes me sort of cringe inside? When ex-nurses post on my videos and they go, Trevor, where are you getting your information from? It wasn't like that when I worked in the NHS in 1992. No, it wasn't. Yeah, you worked many, many years ago. Things have changed. Things change overnight. Yeah. Oh, by the way, Trevor, those TVs that go above the bed have nothing to do with the NHS. It's a private company. Yes, it is a private company. Where does the money come from? Yeah, NHS Trust. Exactly. These things come out of bills, by the way. A private company doesn't just go, oh, we'll put the TVs in for free. No, they don't. It costs a fortune. People make money on the back of it. Of course they do. Listen, companies don't do things for free. The NHS doesn't buy things because it's life-saving equipment. No, they buy it to make the jobs easier. And a lot of it's not life-saving equipment. You've just heard about that young guy, Gregor, that died. Yeah. We have a lazy, lazy health service today. We really do. Yes, I know that some of the nurses work long hours and shifts. I mean, I can't win with the NHS. I can't even win with nurses. Because in one video, I'll say, oh, the NHS, the nurses work really, really hard. And, you know, they don't get really, and the money's not great. And then a nurse will post, well, I get really good money, Trevor. And I'm like, okay, well, you get really good money. And someone will say, well, I don't get paid enough. Listen, I'm going to say this. I'm going to go out on a limb. See, if you're a nurse and you're using a food bank, you've made bad choices. It's quite clear. You're living in an area which is more expensive than you can probably afford to live. You've taken out a mortgage which you can't repay. Maybe you're driving a flash car and you shouldn't be. Drop your car down to an ordinary car like the rest of us. Maybe you've made bad choices. Maybe you've got too many credit cards. Maybe your phone's worth $2,000. Listen, if you're having to, I know that there is ordinary families that use food banks, and I'm not saying that bad life choices. Some of us don't have a choice. But not all nurses are using food banks. They're not. It's to do with life choices, people, isn't it? Don't live in an area too expensive for your income. I'll get shot down for saying that, but you know what? It's only my opinion. What else? I used to think Big Brother, the TV show Big Brother, was Channel 4. I used to think it was Channel 4. Well, apparently it's ITV. I've just read about it. ITV bosses have spent over £2 million so far in bringing people in for the next Big Brother. We know they've got Sarah Ferguson coming in, the Duchess of York. Louis Walsh is going in there now. And who else is going in? And I think it's a waste of money, but I think she's got a PR agent pushing to get her money because she's skint. Rebecca Vardy. Yep, the woman that would sink ships. Her with her big gob that would sink ships. She'll give away your secrets, won't she? Yeah, so Rebecca Vardy's going in it now as well. Bit sad. But there we go. She's not my cup of tea. But I'm sure she's someone's glass of whiskey. Yeah. Thanks, Hazel, for that. Yeah. Well, people, listen, I'm going to shoot on. I'm going to try and have a wonderful day. I'm going to spend some time with my son today. Yeah. Well, thank you. I want to say thank all of you for your continued support on my channel. And we're going to move forward. We're going to move forward, have a wonderful year. We don't have any restrictions with YouTube. Well, we do have restrictions with YouTube. But now it's we've reached that happy medium, haven't we, people? We've reached a happy medium. Thanks for your support. Thanks to you, those of you that keep leaving reviews on Amazon. Thank you very much for the books. I mean, for buying the books and leaving the reviews, good or bad. I enjoy reading them. I learn from them. I get to see where I'm going wrong. So that's great. Always educational. But keep positive. Keep moving forward. It's a new year. Thanks for supporting this channel. It means a lot. Have a great day, everyone. And stay safe.